Welcome to my channel.
Environmental Studies Part 2, Standard 5. What is history? History, a science that tells us about events in the past. Last year in Standard 4, we study the life of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj and his mission of establishing Swaraj. The time before the birth of Shivaji Maharaj was about 400 years before now, or in the other words, the time 400 years ago. For our convenience, we divide time in different ways. Often we use words like now, sometime ago, after some time, or today, yesterday, tomorrow, or this year, next year, etc. When we use these words, we are actually measuring time in our minds. Now, today, and this year are terms that indicate the present. Some time ago, yesterday, and last year are terms that indicate the past. After some time, tomorrow, and next year are words that indicate the future. The time that has already gone by is the past. The time that we are in now is the present. The time that is yet to come is the future. The past includes many events that have already taken place. For example, if you are 10 years old today, it means that the events of your birth happened 10 years ago in the past. Similarly, after 10 years from now, that is, in future, you will be 20 years old. The time gone by between today and the day of your birth is your past, the past in the life of a person. The science that tries to understand past event is called history. The scientific method of history. In standard 3rd and 4, as part of environmental studies, we have become acquainted with various sciences. The special characteristics of all these sciences is that their facts or evidence can be tested in experiments which can be repeated anywhere, anytime. The method of using number of different tests to determine whether the evidence is reliable is called the scientific method. There are many things that happen since our birth that we may not know about. However, our grandparents or parents or others often tell us amusing stories of our childhood. Those stories are a part of their memory. However, when different people tell us about the same event, we find differences in their narration. It makes us wonder which one is right. We need to examine the details of each narration carefully to decide the correctness of the fact. It is not possible to conduct experiments to recreate the events that have happened in the past. Therefore, the method of presenting history is different from that of other sciences. Even so, history uses the scientific method at every stage, namely while looking for and collecting evidence, examine the evidence, and while putting it together, when required, help is also taken from other sciences. That is why history is considered to be a scientific discipline. History is not written solely on the basis of imagination. Ancient objects, structure, sculpture, pots, coins, inscriptions, copper plates, books, manuscripts, traditional stories, and songs remembered over many generations, etc., are the sources of history. The sources of history are of three types. First, material sources. Second, written sources. method, oral sources, in order to find out what happened in the past and how it happened. Evidence available from all these sources is collected and thoroughly examined to determine its reliability. With the help of the evidence that stands this test, past events are put in proper sequence and historical account is written. This is the scientific method. History and us. The study of science helps us to find the answer to many questions. For example, environmental science studies the problem of degradation of the environment, pollution, etc., and looks for their solution. In the same way, every science has its own areas of study. History studies events of the past. Individual or collective action of human beings have consequences. They result in an environment that may be either favorable or unfavorable for the progress of society. This affects our day-to-day life. For example, if the people of a village work together and help one another, the village makes good progress. However, if the people cannot come together, it puts obstacle in the way of its development. History attempt to find out the answer to many questions by studying the way of thinking of past societies, their actions and the consequences. The study of history makes it possible for us to study what is and what is not favorable for the progress of human society. History thus provides us with the guidelines about how we should behave today in order to shape a good future. By telling us the life stories of great people, history also serves to inspire and to motivate us. By studying history, we get to know about the give and take that took place between our own and other civilizations. We learn about the progress of human civilization. We also understand how people's way of life went on changing. Every village, city, district, state, and country has its own history. Similarly, the earth, its mountain, water bodies, the animal world, mankind, all have their own history. Every science too has a history. It tells of many scientific discoveries that brought about important changes in human civilization and of the scientists who made those discoveries. The past and the future. The past, present and future are linked by a continuous chain of events. For example, the Indian people fought against the British government to get independence. This is a historical action. As a result, India became an independent nation on 15th August 1947. So we can say that independence was a consequence of an action, that is the Indian people's struggle for independence. In this way, the events of today are linked with past actions. When we understand this, we realize that the future depends on the past events. This is what we learn from history. For example, we learn that man began to make the tools from material available in nature. That he learned how to make use of fire and that he invented the wheel. The next generation added to these developments. Technology developed further hand in hand with the physical and intellectual development of man. This process is going on continuously even today. Inventions of today are only possible on the foundation of the discoveries and invention of the past. Question number 1. Fill in the blanks. A. The science that tries to understand past event is called - History. B. History is not written solely on the basis of dash imagination. See, the time that has already gone by is the dash past. D. The dash include many events that have already taken place. Past. E. History is considered to be a dash discipline. Scientific. Question number 2. Answer each question in one sentence. A. What is the scientific method? Answer. The method of using a number of different tests to determine whether the evidence is reliable is called the scientific method. B. Of which action is India's independence the result? Answer. Independence of India is the consequence, the result of the struggle of the people of India for independence. C. What does the study of history make possible? Answer. The study of history make it possible for us to study what is not favorable for the progress of society. D. What is the special characteristics of science? Answer. Testing of facts or evidence in experiments which can be repeated anywhere and anytime is the special characteristics of science. E. State the types of history. Answer. The sources of history are of three types. First, material sources. Second, written sources. Third, oral sources. Question number 3. Answer the following questions in brief. First, why is the history considered to be a scientific discipline? Answer. History is considered to be a scientific discipline due to the following reasons. First, history uses scientific method while looking for and collecting evidence. Second, it uses scientific method while examining the evidence and putting it together. Third, help is taken from other science when required. Second, what is it that puts obstacle in the way of village development? Answer. The obstacle in the way of village developments are: people in the village do not work together and people in the village do not help one another. Question number 4. Complete the concept chart. History. Nation. World. Human civilization. My own. Of a school. Of a village. District. State. Question number 5. Classify the sources of history using the chart given here. Sources of history: coins, letters, fort, traditional songs, pots, copper plates, old structure, stone inscription, folk song, pillars, biographies, rock, cut caves, folk tales. Answer. Material: coins, forts, pots, old structure, pillars, rock cut caves. Written: letters, copper plates, stone inscriptions, biographies. Oral: traditional songs, folk song, folk tales.
Please like and subscribe my channel. Visit my website komalahira.com.
Thanks for watching.